tranquil, serene, scenic, and off the beaten path. Welcome to Playon Sur and Hakoti, two sleepy little towns on the Pacific coast of Costa Rica, a country renowned worldwide for its respect for nature and commitment to peace. Having abolished its army over 60 years ago, Costa Rica also declared peace with nature in 2007, vowing to abolish the forces that destroy it. Yet something is now both disrupting the environment and disturbing the peace here in these quiet coastal communities. It started suddenly, without warning, back in January this year and has continued just about every day since. The horrible sounds and noxious odors from a banana plantation's crop-dusting plane flying low over the fields, streams, roads, rivers, homes, and entire community. Beginning most days just before sunrise, the plane flies continuously for 2 to 3 hours, spewing agrochemicals indiscriminately over everything. The schools, the health clinics, and anyone walking or riding along the roads. The people are at their wits' end on how to deal with it.
The people from Hakoti and Playon Sur were there before a banana plantation that has been developed lately. Their life, the pattern of life, the one that they had before has dramatically changed from night to day. And they don't know where to go. They don't know if the municipality is the right place to go, if the Ministry of Health, the local area of health in Parrita is competent to regulate this. What about the Ministry of the Environment? They have not been informed. Suddenly, they were waking every morning by the sound of a plane that seems that is going to attack the town, and not the banana plantation. And also having the burden to breathe a substance that is not innocuous.
Sí, toda la comunidad la afectan, sí, porque ellos ocupan bastante espacio para regar, entonces no solo en las plantaciones. En las plantaciones los trabajadores lo reciben directamente, pero sí, alrededor de la comunidad, ahí también les llega porque los aviones andan con las boquillas malas, entonces siguen tirando, y después que ellos, que terminan de regar una plantación, pasan como 50, 60 metros todavía soltando los químicos, los venenos, entonces todas las personas reciben esos malos olores, esos químicos, y padecen mucho de asma y de enfermedades, más que todo en los pulmones y respiratorios. Pero más que todo ahora estas bananeras, porque ellas cubren toda la ribera del río. Entonces ahí es donde más se contamina. Las afuentes que caen al río y el río.
Para mí son ruidos y ahí que hay en ciertas ocasiones pasan tirando el químico y eso da picazón. O sea, a veces y aquí también hay niños pequeños. Y eso va a perturbar, eso le molesta. Y es, cuando pasan con el químico y merece caerle a uno, es en la tarde, es una picazón muy, muy seria. El avión pasa por encima ahí regando y él no le importa nada. Entonces, si uno habla con ellos y dice, no, ya vamos a arreglar eso. Y yo veo la misma situación.
La avioneta transita en la mañana, 5 de la mañana, está transitando la avioneta. Ella pasa por todos los lugares con ruidos muy fuertes. Entonces, posiblemente nos afecta a todos en la bulla en la mañana y también en el aire, que cuando ya la compañía está regando veneno, entonces todo este aire llega a nuestras casas y lo inhalamos, lo absorbemos. Pensamos que no es lo mejor, porque sabemos de que este líquido, este producto, no es bueno para la piel, para los pulmones y para la salud. Aquí tenemos una conciencia y sabemos que es malo, pero la gente no sabe cómo denunciarlo, cómo hablar o a dónde pedir ayuda.
These people, people that have lived in a very rural area for so many years, suddenly are faced with something that they don't know how to fight. And I don't think that the right word might be fight. I would say that they don't know how to live with in harmony with them, or what can they do to make this business or this plantation to be socially responsible and friendly with its community.
To help the people of the area where he grew up, environmental attorney Jorge Jimenez Cordero organized a few informal town hall style meetings to explain the laws and the people's rights. And just as the first was about to begin, a busload of banana workers showed up carrying signs. With sober faces, the workers held up their slogans. We are 1,000 workers. We want to work. Association organized here to defend our workers. You want to destroy the economy of the town of Perita. We are single mothers who need our work. And the xenophobic gringo, go home.
I attended a meeting that was intended for the community. And I went into the community, this community meeting, and it was myself and my business partner were the only two gringos, or North Americans, in this meeting. And there was so much what I call xenophobia or hatred towards Americans, and signs that said, gringo, go home.
Robert Hunter is an officer in a corporation that owns almost 90 acres in a residential project on a hill adjacent to the banana plantation, Frutas Selectas del Trópico. And like many in the community, he is very disturbed by the noise of the airplane early in the morning and the dangerous chemicals being dropped overhead.
We don't understand why they're blaming us. We just showed up at the meeting, and there were all of these pickets and signs against us, and it was obviously against us. There was one instance in the meeting where one of the gentlemen was actually ranting about gringos and wars and us being the cause of ill all over the planet, and he was pointing at me. So it was very intimidating to me.
¿Cómo pretende un extranjero? Bueno, hay mucho capital extranjero, eso es obvio. Aquí hay mucho capital extranjero. ¿Cómo pretende un extranjero venir a tener paz ahí y dejar a 1,000 trabajadores sin trabajo o dejar a una comunidad sin trabajo? No. ¿Cómo pretende un extranjero de los Estados Unidos venir a decirnos a nosotros que no contaminamos el mundo, que no contaminamos el ambiente? Yo creo que usted es ambientalista. Que no contaminamos el ambiente si ellos son los mayores contaminadores del mundo con las guerras. ¿Ah?
The only war the few so-called gringos that live in the area wish to wage is the same one the Costa Ricans have been battling, to stop the rampant spraying of toxic chemicals overhead and bring peace and quiet back to these communities.
We have no desire to stop the cultivation of bananas. We only have the desire to modify and end the fumigation of bananas via airplanes. And we have total respect for the local community and for the workers that need those jobs for their families. We're not out to shut down the farm.
Nosotros no estamos en contra de los que trabajan en la compañía. Nosotros estamos en contra es de la forma de aplicación que ellos tienen. Entonces, si existe algún método que se pueda cambiar para que eso se solucione, no hay ningún problema.
La salud es lo primordial en esta vida y todos nos da miedo. Pero lo que queremos es que ellos cumplan las normas que se le ha estipulado a ellos de que dejen de fumigar o que cierren las boquillas de la avioneta en su determinado momento y que el aire no los traiga hacia nosotros tampoco. Yo creo que aparte de ser un problema de norteamericanos, es un problema de la comunidad en general. O sea, esto nos afecta no solo a nosotros, si en esta zona también hay muchos extranjeros, norteamericanos hay bastante en estas zonas, y también yo creo que ellos se han unido también a nosotros que somos ticos.
It's mostly the Tico community that's upset. There are very few gringos who live in this area, in this neighborhood. I've been in Costa Rica for almost 9 years. My husband is Costa Rican. Most of our friends are Costa Rican. I don't hang out in a gringo community. And it's mostly the Costa Ricans who are angry at this plane. They're worried for their homes. They're worried for their children in the school. They're worried for this entire neighborhood.
But the banana company claims it would be too costly to change the method of fumigation.
Aplicación de agroquímicos por otros medios. Desgraciadamente, en la industria agrícola, sobre todo en banano, los costos son muy importantes. Existiendo leyes y existiendo reglamentos que deben de ser aplicados, yo creo que es un poco demagógico empezar a hablar de que debemos de usar otros sistemas y cosas de estas porque no son aplicables. Desgraciadamente, las plantaciones de banano requieren de una cantidad muy grande de fungicidas. Si no, no hay producción y no tiene ningún sentido el tenerlas. Y no hay otra forma más económica de aplicación que esta.
Demagógico, demagogic, a word not commonly used, but it has two meanings. Championing the cause of the common people, which is what those helping the local people are trying to do, and prone to make use of popular prejudices, false claims, and promises in order to gain power, which is exactly what the banana company appears to be doing.
Lo que sí se debe hacer es aplicar las leyes y reglamentos para evitar lo que usted habla de la salud, de los problemas, que a mí me da la impresión de que hay una relación cronológica entre ese proyecto turístico y esta, llamémosle, deseos de que exista un poquito más de tranquilidad.
The desire for a little more tranquility is true, but a tourism project? That was a total fabrication, a lie told to the banana workers to make them feel that they would be losing their jobs to foreign interests.
There's some rumor that we're out to put in some sort of tourist attraction. I have no interest in that. Our corporation is not involved in that at all. We have no idea where this rumor has started up. We believe that it's the company, the banana company, that has started this rumor in an attempt to harass us and create ill will against the local American community.
And it wasn't long before workers driving out the front gate of the banana plantation were making serious threats.
And the car headed almost directly towards the front of my car in a very aggressive way, and the man started making comments that were half in Spanish and half in English. But the English comments were, "Gringo, go home, gringo, go home." And they were saying all sorts of things in Spanish that I didn't really understand, because my Spanish is not that good. But I did understand their physical gestures, and they were doing a gesture where they were leaning their head over and chopping on the neck like this, and one of the other ones was doing his hand like he had a machete in his hand. And they did use one word that I did recognize, which is the Spanish word mataron, which I believe to be mean we will kill, or you will die, you will be killed.
Understandably intimidated, Hunter wants the workers to know that he has no intentions to take away their livelihood.
We're not out to get any of the workers fired. They all have families and needs. We want them all to continue with their jobs. We only want to modify the application of agrochemicals. We want to end the aerial fumigation.
When agrochemicals have been sprayed aerially over banana crops in many other parts of the world, including the Caribbean coast of Costa Rica, horrible health problems have been documented, from skin problems and breathing disorders to cancers and sterility. And the Frutas Selectas del Tropico plantation is flagrantly violating Costa Rican law.
The law that regulates the spreading of these agrochemicals precisely forbids the pilots or the companies that are servicing these plantations to go near rivers, to go near towns. They are actually obliged to respect certain areas of protection. They are also obliged to follow certain pattern that will avoid not only noise, but also the drive of the wind that might bring to sites that should not be sprayed any residues of these pesticides or these agrochemicals. And I don't think that this is the case.
Just one look at this home video makes it clear that the chemicals are being sprayed directly into the streams and over the roadways. And the banana company admits their main focus is costs, not the cost to human health or life, but in dollars, or quetzals, or even cordobas, since the land is owned by a Guatemalan company and more than half of the workers are Nicaraguan. And whether Tico or Nica, the workers are not happy about being sprayed. One former worker told us his doctor advised him to quit when he started having breathing problems, but others cannot afford to quit.
Necesitan el dinero y si renuncian pierden todo. Perdón, ellos prefieren estar ahí aguantando malos olores y enfermándose antes de quedarse sin sustento para la familia.
Lamentablemente es triste decir esto, pero ¿qué pasa? Los trabajadores por la vida tan difícil que está, se aguantan cualquier cosa por interés del trabajo porque lo necesitan. Creo que no es justo esto. Sabiendo lo que están haciendo, que es veneno, porque es veneno, porque yo llamé a la Cruz Roja y ese muchacho estaba todo quemado, toda esta parte aquí así, de los químicos que llevan ahí, llegan al banano. Y él, por no perder el trabajo, mire, boquita cerrada. No, eso no es justo. No, eso no es justo.
Most people don't like to complain, they don't like to cause difficulties, they just suffer and bear it because they're worried about repercussions. The banana plantation is very powerful and they're worried about jobs and any repercussions in the community. They all talk about it amongst themselves, but they don't do much until things get organized for them because they're worried about backlash.
Many in the community are thrilled to have help from anyone who can assist in their efforts to stop this toxic spraying.
Si ellos quieren, ellos pueden ayudarnos. Todo está en que ellos quieran. Porque lo que pasó en Guápiles, en Limón, en Siquirres, puede pasar aquí. Ellos de veras pueden respetar la ley. Si hay ley para esto, pueden respetarla, que se haga respetar nada más.
Soy tico, vivimos en un país de derecho donde no podemos ver quién es extranjero o quién no es extranjero para poder quejarse. Yo no soy un trabajador de la bananera, pero también vivo de un trabajo. No se trata de quitarle el trabajo a nadie. Los mismos derechos que tienen allá, tenemos otra gente afuera de trabajar. Lo mismo tenemos derecho de ganarnos nuestro sustento tranquilo.
Costa Ricans have become very aware of their rights. And sometimes they might not have the right information, but I have seen that once they have the right information, once they are addressed with what they can do, what they cannot do, what will they expect from this complaint, they might be eager to take a course of action.
In a country whose tourism slogan is no artificial ingredients, it's good to know that the rights to a clean and healthy living environment belong to everyone.
Even before the Constitution of Costa Rica was amended to include the right to enjoy of a sound environment, this chamber has been interpreting the Constitution by granting the right of any inhabitant of the country. And when I'm saying inhabitant, I'm not talking only about Costa Ricans. Any person that drops by Costa Rica, even a tourist, have the right to even file a complaint before this chamber to seek for protection. They have the right to demand from the state and even from private individuals, demand the right to live in an environment, on a sound environment and in equilibrium with nature. And I think that that equilibrium with nature and a sound environment has been disrupted.
Pero me preocupa mucho escuchar que los chiquitos cuando van para la escuela, les cae el agua del avión y yo creo que es obvio. Yo le pregunté a los señores, o sea, es claro, si la calle está aquí nomás y los chiquitos tienen que pasar. A mí me parece muy bien que haya venido alguien que nos asesore, porque ¿con qué nos vamos a sentar a negociar con alguien que tiene abogados y que tiene todo y quién va a poner el dinero para que haya una persona que nos asesore? Seamos extranjeros, seamos nacionales, sea un proyecto turístico, sea un proyecto agrícola. Entonces, yo no veo por qué, quién pagó, quién no pagó, quién se beneficia, quién se empeora, quién se va a quedar sin trabajo, quién se va a morir. No, o sea, es un problema de todos.
It is everyone's responsibility, because foreign or national, we all want the same things.
Tienen que prevenir antes de que pasen las consecuencias, porque ya cuando pasan ya uno no puede hacer nada. Ahora estamos a tiempo. Estamos a tiempo y yo les doy todo el apoyo porque yo fui una víctima de eso, porque me enfermaron los bronquios y todavía tengo consecuencias. Todavía tengo consecuencias y nosotros llevamos niños para arriba que ellos, uno espera que no reciban esos malos hábitos, porque son malos hábitos eso de estar fumigando indiscriminadamente y con químicos que están prohibidos en Estados Unidos.
Tengo 8 niños, queremos, en Costa Rica no queremos químicos, queremos que sea un país limpio, con el aire y toda la gente que viva feliz en este lugar, en Costa Rica.